Abu Khair al-Masri was the number two worldwide of the terrorist organization. He was an Egyptian operative who had long-standing ties to al-Qaeda, to bin Laden, particularly to Ayman al-Zawahiri, the current leader of al-Qaeda. He was in Afghanistan before 9/11, and after the fall of the Taliban, then traveled to Iran, trying to flee that country, but he was taken into custody by the Iranians and spent a number of years under arrest in Iran. Well, about a year ago, he managed to get out of Iran. They released him and managed to travel back to Syria, where he was appointed al-Qaeda's global number two. So this is a very significant breakthrough against the terrorist group worldwide, somebody who in Syria presumably was able to communicate back with Ayman al-Zawahiri, who he knew very well, to communicate and to coordinate actions between Syria and between al-Qaeda central back in the Afghan-Pakistan border region. But I think we have to be careful not to exaggerate his importance either. He wasn't a jihadi superstar like bin Laden, like Ayman al-Zawahiri. Back before 9/11, he essentially managed the travel logistics for al-Qaeda. He was described to me by one former al-Qaeda operative as being very bookish. He was often mocked for that by other al-Qaeda operatives. So he wasn't a natural-born leader, but he was one of the veteran al-Qaeda operatives still around, and that gave him standing in the terrorist group. And so certainly his death will be a loss for them.